Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God. It's the Revelator once again. And hoping the grace and the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you until the end of time. We meet once again in the fifth segment, the part five, the ongoing presentation, the mind-blowing season. The series inside the Word of God, the divination system, part five. And I'm praying that the Holy Spirit has been empowering you from part one, two, three, and four, where many diversities of the Word were offloaded by the Holy Spirit, many exposures. Many dimensions that exposed the divination system. I'm praying that you are being enlightened to understand the depth of the word that is being ministered. Now, I want to welcome you to the fifth segment, which is now part five, the divination system. And I'm not going to be taking you back into what was covered from part one to part four, but I'm praying that the Holy Spirit is giving you the adequate understanding in this series presentation. Now, in the divination system part five, let us get into scriptures in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 28 verse 5. And in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 28 verse 5, it reads, "And when Saul saw that the host of the Philistine were afraid, and his heart greatly trembled, Saul inquired of the Lord, and the Lord answered him not, neither by dreams nor by prophets." Now, before I explain the scripture passage that I've read, I want you to know that Saul has been anointed as a king. And after being anointed as a king, he walks out of the presence of God and is rejected by Prophet Samuel. And up until Prophet Samuel goes to sleep, Saul has already been rejected. And Prophet Samuel is now dead. Now, the voice that used to speak to Saul has departed. And Saul still needs to inquire the voice of God. But now the one that projected the voice of God to Saul as a king is now dead. And this is the passage that I'm currently reading, where the Lord answered him not by dreams, not even by prophets, meaning that the voice that was speaking unto Saul during that era and that season was the voice of Prophet Samuel, and Samuel is now dead. "Then said Saul unto his servants, seek me a woman that has a familiar spirit." As I welcome you to the fifth presentation of the divination system, I want to present the subtitle, Familiar Spirits in the Divination System, so that you may understand that there is a league of spirits that group up with the diviners in the spirit. There is a legion of familiar spirits that is led by the divination spirit, a class of demons, a class of deceitful spirits that operate as undercover agents in the kingdom of darkness, in the area of dark influence that is deceitful and that operates within the body of Christ, or within those that have the presence of God and within the spheres of God's work. And Saul inquires unto his servants and says, "Seek me a woman that has a familiar spirit." It means Saul was aware that this woman would familiarize. A familiar spirit is not exactly the original reflection of the actual spirit, but it is familiar. It familiarizes. To familiarize with a certain particular spirit is to act on behalf or to act like yet it is not the actual spirit. And his servant said to him, behold, there is a woman with a familiar spirit at Endor. And Saul disguised himself and put on other raiment and went with two men into the city where this woman was found. Why? Because in that era, King Saul had earlier put a rule that anyone who would be found in any act that regards any familiar spirit or any witch consultation would be put to death. Now King Saul is going against the rules that he himself was enforcing as a king. The same rules that were restricted by Prophet Samuel before he died. The same rules that had been erected. The same regulations that had been put during the times of Prophet Moses. And Saul disguised himself and put on other raiment and went with two men. And they came to the woman by night. And he said, I pray thee, divine. I'll repeat that part. And he said, I pray thee, divine unto me by the familiar spirit. Saul is saying, divine unto me. Meaning that before we talk about the familiar spirit, Saul understands that there should be a divination process in the spirit. That the familiar spirit must first enter into the portal that reacts under the spiritual divine operations. I pray thee, divine unto me by the familiar spirit, and bring me up whom I shall name. What a familiar spirit does is that it portrays any character. It is able to impersonate any character. What a familiar spirit does under the divine motivation of the divination dark systems is that it is able to bring up any character. It is able to play any character. It is able to play even the characters of the activities of the divine motivations that are programmed or demonstrated under the works of the Holy Spirit, yet it does not project the original characteristics, but it does impersonate the works that are found under the body of Christ. So this woman is a spirit that can play any character. The divine operations under the divination systems that this woman plays is that this woman is able to play any whatsoever character that you want. This type of spirit is able to bring up any character of any man of God. This spirit is able to play any character of any prophet. It is able to play any character of any gift inside the fivefold. This character is able to play any character when it comes to miracles in the acts of the spirit. This character is able to play any character when it comes to the divine dimensions under the Holy Spirit. Yet it does not portray the original character of the Holy Spirit. I hope someone is understanding what I'm saying. And this woman is asking, whom shall I bring you up? Whom is it that you inquire? Why? Because it's a familiar spirit. Now, Saul had to swear unto this woman that He was not going to go against this woman. Why? Because he himself as a king was the one that had put the laws that go against any diviners that operate in that land of Israel. And so swear to it by the Lord, saying, as the Lord liveth, there shall be no punishment happening for this thing. When divination is being allowed by he that holds a higher position in the kingdom of God, when divination is being given a breakthrough door by them that are fathers of faith, I have mentioned this in the previous parts. When divination is now being allowed by those that are gatekeepers inside the body of Christ, by those that are watchers in the realm of the body of Christ, it becomes chaotic. Then said the woman, who shall I bring up? And he said, bring me up Samuel. Samuel, the prophet, is already deceased. Samuel, the prophet, is already going to sleep. But the familiar spirit under the divine system, under the divination system, is able to bring up any character. Why? Because it is able to play any character. What it means is that anything that you might have seen another man or woman of God doing, a familiar spirit is able to play that character. It will play that character so perfectly to the level that you'll be impressed and you'll be convinced that the Holy Spirit is at work, yet it is not the Holy Spirit. And what King Saul needs here is to hear the voice of Prophet Samuel. He is eager. He is so obsessed with the voice of Prophet Samuel. This is happening in this generation, where you have the voice of a certain man of God, you have the voice of a certain spiritual father, a voice of a certain prominent popular prophet. You are not common with the voice of God. You are not common with the voice of Jesus Christ. You are not common with the voice of the Holy Spirit. All you need is to hear the voice of that man, and the familiar spirits are going to give you exactly what you're searching for. And it becomes a system when the whole nation is eager to hear one voice. It becomes a system of divination. It becomes a system that is empowered by one familiar spirit. There is the chief commander of familiar spirits that assigns the familiar spirits to enter Christians. And they operate under one program of divination that is empowered by a system of familiar spirits that are following a code that is operating under one divine system, under the kingdom of darkness that is being inspired by false light. And the woman brings up Samuel, and when the woman saw Samuel, she cried with a loud voice. There are two spirits that are at work here. I need you to understand something here. The two spirits that are at work here is that the woman is possessed by a divine spirit, and the divine spirit opens the portal for the familiar spirit, and the familiar spirit ascends from the pit of hell, ascends from the underworld, portraying the character of a prophet that is already deceased, and it starts speaking and acting in the spiritual dimension on the behalf of a prophet that is already dead. And that prophet is not Prophet Samuel, but that familiar spirit starts operating as Prophet Samuel just to create a false conviction inside a king that leads Israel. And while this king is doing this, the whole of Israel is getting possessed. I want you to understand that once a prophet of a nation a prophet that is operating at a national level. Once a king that is operating at a national level, once a president that is operating at a national level has been possessed by one chief diviner that is operating inside the national prophet, the whole nation gets possessed by the spirit of divination. And this is exactly what is happening here. Why? Because King Saul, you are being possessed by a system that will take over the whole nation. Why? Because you have been given the keys as a gate watcher, as a gatekeeper, as a watcher of Israel, as a king. And you are seeking clarity from the wrong sources in the spirit on behalf of a nation. And the woman saw Samuel, but it was not Samuel that was ascending from the ground. And she cried with a loud voice. And the woman spoke to Saul, saying, "Why have you deceived me? Are you Saul? Are you not Saul?" Why? Because all along the woman did not know that this was Saul. I want you to understand something. The blindness of a deceitful diviner is that she cannot tell the practical image of the character up until the spirit is ascended from the earth. This is why you realize that when a diviner is operating, she's not aware of what is happening whilst the spirit is taken over. She's only aware when she comes back after the possession has departed away from her spiritual body or his spiritual body. She operates under an impartation of that spirit. She's not conscious, or he's not conscious, to what is happening. It's like an impartation power that would have taken over. And so many are operating under that divination program where they are not aware, where they are not totally aware of what is happening. They are just being used as vessels of a certain agenda by Lucifer, who appears as an angel of light. And the king said unto her, "Be not afraid, for what did you see?" And the woman said unto Saul, "I saw gods ascending out of the earth." The gods that the woman saw ascending out of the earth, those are gods of divination. They are gods of divination that have ascended out of the earth and hijacked the body of Christ, hijacking the elect of God, hijacking the system and the operations of churches and denominations, hijacking a nation, hijacking the counsel that is being given to politicians. And the system of divination continues possessing the nation at a national level and electing into offices even respectable figures that are not anointed by the Holy Spirit. I hope someone is understanding what I'm saying here as I'm presenting the divination system part 5. A system that is not elected by God, but a system that has hijacked men and women of God, and they are not aware. They are believing that this is God that is speaking, but God is quiet. And the spirit that came out, it was a familiar spirit under the divination program, and it spoke unto Saul. It was able to predict exactly the events that were going to befall Saul. And Saul died in the battle the next day. Saul fell upon the sword, as was predicted by this spirit, that Saul was going to die in the next day alongside his son. Child of God, I'm here once again to present and to represent the Holy Spirit as I expose the divination program, the divination system, the system of the gods that ascended out of the earth. I'm here to expose a system that has already entered inside church, a system that has already entered inside the body of Christ. And I, as the voice that ministers unto the seven churches, I have been given a mandate to paralyze that spirit by addressing the truth unto the seven churches in the name of Jesus.